Stryker, and we obviously didn't need any help bringing this bed in. He drove it in all by himself.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I should have brought a pot of coffee on the table, I'm sure. So, being the last one of the day. Again, my name is Tracy Westrom, so I'm with Stryker. I deal with the surgical tables, also working with the booms, lights, and integration, everything that's going on, the new six rooms and the PCP as well, too. This is our Berchtold DH60 surgical table that we're going to be trialing here. A couple things about it. First of all, sorry, I'm going to get one more accessory. I'm out of breath. Out of shape. It's about 2 inches wider than your current tables. So, not saying there isn't a need for some bariatric extenders at times, but it does eliminate that need a lot, and we obviously have them if you need them. It's also 1,000 pounds in any articulation. So, this is head, this is foot. As long as we keep it that way, it's 1,000 pounds. Trend, reverse trend, anything like that, and you'll be fine. If for whatever reason we reverse the patient, which you should not have to, because this also has full slide from head to foot, but if you do, it drops to 500 pounds if you reverse the patient. Again, that's in the articulation. If I keep it static and don't move the table at all and just keep it centered like it is now, then it's 1,200 pounds. But I really don't even talk about that. Hopefully we don't ever have to talk about that, or 1,000. Table goes down to 21 inches, so gets very low. It also goes up to 46 inches. A lot of people are like, well, why in the heck would I want to go that high? There's obviously fall surgeons, you get bariatric, or excuse me, not bariatric, but I see them in some ERCP cases and some things like that where they want it close to the C-arm. The C-arm can't go down any farther, and they do like that flexibility with it. Hand pennant right here, obviously. I'll just talk through the controls briefly on it. But I do want to mention there's also, if you'll see, you can't see it there, but there's a fully functional backup hand pennant here. So if this gets broken, ran over, anything like that, pop it out, plug it in where this one is, and it works as a second hand pendant for you. Also, there's, if everything goes wrong with it, there is a hydraulic here with it that will pop out, and the hydraulic, it lights up what you can use with it. You wouldn't want to do surgery all day with it, but if just to get the patient back in a steady position, you can hold the button, push the pump, and it will do what you're asking it to do with that. So again, just another form of backup there with it. You all saw a second ago, this table will drive itself. Go and I say itself, you're controlling it. But it'll go forward and backwards. If you're having to move the tables a lot from room to room, anything like that, a lot of facilities do like that capability. It is easy to move without the instant drive. But for example, you'll see it up here at the top. I hit forward and it's gonna move forward. And then I just control it. Did I hit something? But it'll move forward, it'll move backwards, everything that I want it to do right here. And I just steer it right here with my hand. We do have races occasionally down the hallways with them. So just as far as a hand bend is concerned here, your power button's up at the top left, obviously. When it's lit, it's on. Then you have a floor lock button. If it's not locked and I hit any button on this remote, other than the trend button, it will automatically go and lock itself with it, just as a safety feature. To unlock, so right now I'm gonna go ahead and lock it. I hit any button, you can hear it locking itself right now. So it's locked and in place, I can't move it. To unlock, it's two distinct taps with the floor lock button, just so it doesn't get hit by mistake or anything like that. So two distinct taps, now it's unlocked, and it's ready to move with it, okay? A lot of people just start pushing it real quick. But again, just so it doesn't get hit by mistake, it's two distinct lock and unlocks. You have the reverse and forward. That's the instant drive I just showed you. Also has a battery indicator on it as well, too. This battery, without being plugged in, should give you about 2 weeks without having to plug it in. A lot of people are like, okay, what happens if the battery goes bad? It's not that bad to replace. I think a battery is like $300 or $400. I know in the grants. Yes, that's a lot of money, but in the grand scheme, if this lasts you for 3 or 4 years, and we have to replace it, we can do that with you. With it. If you do want to leave it plugged in, that's fine. It's not going to hurt anything. If it is dead, as soon as you plug it in, it will up and run at that point. Obviously, you have your typical back up, back down, anything like that. You'll be able to trial it for a week, so you'll see the full functionality. Excuse me, full functionality of it. So I won't bore you just with all the details related to that. We do have, I don't know if you saw the big, it looks like a magician box, black box. That's full of accessories. We have way more than that, but we kind of bring the standard ones with us. I brought just a few in here. So if you're going in stirrups or anything, we have a couple options. This is our leg transfer board, very lightweight with it. So the leg section would come off, and I'll show you how to do that. That just comes off. This slides in, lock it, put the patient in stirrups, pull it off. We also have a sling option of this as well, too. I don't have it in the accessory kit, but we have that functionality. We have these tables over at Women's and Children's and MCOS already as well. They do use the sling over there for that. We have a split leg, and I just brought one of them here with me. So I should have said this earlier. You have a head section, a back, seat, and foot. So if I want to go split leg, this is fully integrated into the table. I can control each one of these pegs independently on it here. So if I take this foot section off, again, this is carbon fiber, so very light as far as attachments are concerned with it, and radio translucent with that. But you can see you have these pegs coming off. These are independently controlled. I can control them both at the same time. If I want to lower one leg and raise one or anything like that, I can do that with the remote here with that. And these are the leg sections that go on that portion of it. Also, I wanted to show you, this is a, we call it a TUR plate. Sorry, I don't mean to bang things around. But this also goes on the leg section as well, too. So, a couple reasons for this. A lot of people like to have some, call it a butt pad or anything like that, if they're going in steep reverse trend, and they want to be able to hold the patient. You can slide this on. And I can lift this up, and it will go up to, I believe it's 30 degrees, is how high this portion will go up. It's also nice in urology, GYN, if they want to get farther away from the base. Right now we're at center, so this will come a lot farther down with it. But if you want to get a little bit farther away, you can throw this TUR plate on here as well, too. Other than that, obviously we'll be here all week. There will be somebody, myself or Zach works with me as well, too. We'll be in every single case, so have questions, answers, anything like that, we'll be here to help. Like 3 minutes to spare. Sorry, I tried to make it quick. I know you all are ready to get out of here.
What's the degree of Trans-Dahlberg and the reverse Trans-Dahlberg?
It's 30 degrees both ways.
Does it have a kidney,
Yes, kidney elevator. Right here, we've got a kidney elevator that you can utilize as well. Let me ask you, where would you use a kidney elevator at? What type of procedure?
Thoracic.
Urology.
Okay. Perfect. Yes. So it does have the kidney elevator right here as well, too. So, again, there's a kidney elevator button on here. Excuse me?
How high does it go?
You want me, I can go ahead and show you here real quick. You get a lot. There you go.
When you slide it, how far that way will it go?
How far towards the foot?
Yes.
So again, and something I should have said, as you're utilizing the slide functionality back and forth, it will stop at midline. Okay, so if you think, well, heck, it seems like I should have a lot more slide than that, just so you know you're at the midline of the patient there with it. It will go farther. So right now we're slid down to the foot with that. And then we also have slide to the head as well, too, from that standpoint. I don't know if it's going to be used in robot cases or anything like that as well. Okay, so we don't need to cover that at all with it. But again, we would have that same slide back to the head as well. And if I, there is a level button on here, so you can see it's lower than the split leg, or excuse me, the kidney elevator on it right now. But if I go and let's say I'm in beach chair, and we do have our, will we be utilizing beach chair at all? Okay, mm-hmm. Yeah. So we'll be able to utilize what you have. We also have our beach chair as well too, which is actually takes the back section off, is integrated in the table. There's a beach chair positioning on here. If I just hit the button, it will anatomically position the patient in beach chair. But what I wanted to say is the level button, if you utilize that, it would also put the patient back anatomically correct. So it wouldn't just raise their legs all of a sudden if their back's up. You know, it would raise the legs a little bit, lower the back, raise the legs a little, lower the back, in that manner. Any other questions? Like I said, we'll be here servicing it, play with it as much as you'd like, use the instant drive, people love it, getting room to room. So I appreciate it. I look forward to working with you. Thank you.
Thank you.